went to the African Film Festival with my boyfriend Kadir, and we didn't actually know what the film was going to be about, but we thought, we love the African Film Festival, we should just go and just, you know, it'll be great. So I'm sitting there, Kadir is right next to me, and I'm watching this film, and I soon realize that this film, although it takes place in apartheid South Africa in the 1950s, and it's about the Indian population, it was really about these two women who fell in love. And one of these women was a gardener, and one of the women was a restaurant owner. Weird coincidence. And so I have to tell you that before I was with Kadir, I had dated mostly, not all, but mostly women. And actually, when I started dating Kadir, I had to actually come out to my community because it was like people would just assume by the way that I looked. I had a different haircut, it's like a faux hawk and maybe even a different walk, I don't know. But, you know. I don't know, it happens, but. So I would have to, you know, like people would assume something and I would have to like come out as being in a heterosexual relationship. I mean, you know, obviously there's nothing wrong with heterosexuality. But, you know, I'm cool with that. Cool, but you know that happened, and so I'm sitting there in this film, and I'm like, oh, yeah, and these two women were coming together and having this kind of forbidden love, and it was just so beautiful. And the other thing about my relationship with Kadir was that he was very sweet, so don't hate him when I tell you this, but for our whole entire 2 years together, he wanted to have an open relationship. And I had always said, no way, I cannot do that. Partially because I was afraid that if I started dating a woman, that I would fall head over heels in love with her, and I would break Kadir's heart, and I didn't want to break his heart because I really loved him. We had a great relationship. It was sweet. You know, we had our issues like everybody, but, and so I'm sitting there watching this film on the big screen, and I'm just like, maybe we could have an open. Maybe this could work. We could totally do this. Yeah, I think it could work. Yeah. And so after the film, we talk, and I go to the bookstore and I buy all these books on, you know, the ethical slut and opening up and all these books, and we read and we talk about how we're gonna. We talk about how we're gonna do this and. We come up with all these agreements, and then, you know, we're like, okay, we're gonna do this. You know, felt like a new woman, you know, coming out on the scene. And so he goes out of town, and the next day, I decided to go to this informational meeting about this urban farm project that was starting. And I get to this meeting, nothing had happened in the project yet, it was just very, very beginning. And I get to the meeting, and I look around the room, and I'm like, oh my god, there are like all lesbians here that I don't know already. This is great. I'm thinking to myself, like, okay, but play it cool, you know. So I go to, so that happened. So I go to work the next day, and I'm in my truck, because I have a landscaping business, so that's why I was in my truck. And I get a text message from an unknown caller that said, want to have coffee? And I was like, don't people fucking work in this town? Like, it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Who is wanting to have coffee with me at 9 o'clock in the morning on a Thursday? I'm just so annoyed, and I text back, who is this anyway? I'm working. And, you know, like, come on. And the person texts back, it's God. And I was like, who is this person? And so we kind of text back and forth flirtatiously for a little while, not knowing. I didn't know who this person was.
text back and forth, and I'm like, okay, who is this? And then the word on the phone said, it's Jeanette. And I thought, oh, Jeanette, that's the person who started the Urban Farm Project, whose house I went to yesterday. She's also a restaurant owner. But we keep hanging out. But the next couple weeks turn into kind of a series of flirtatious text messages and me trying to impress her with shoveling compost as fast as I possibly can. And also manhandling an old Italian rototiller. And I really did manhandle that Italian rototiller. Rototilling is many places. That was before we did the sheet mulching. for those of you gardeners out there. And so it kind of went on, and of course I was communicating with Kadir at the same time about, you know, this is happening, this thing. And then one night we were on our way back from a meeting, a Monday night meeting, a planning meeting for this Urban Farm Collective project. And so we're on our way home from the meeting. She's giving me a ride home. And she's, you know, asking me if I'd seen this YouTube video about this particular comedian that was really, really, really funny. And I was like, no, I haven't seen that. And she was like, well, you should totally come over and watch it. And I'm like, yes! I'm totally gonna go over. So I went over to her house and watched the YouTube video, and she fixed me a cocktail, and it was the most exquisite hot toddy I have ever. It was so well crafted, and I was just like melting in my seat because that just made me like her even more. And then, so we watch a movie, and then we talk about things like thunder and lightning, all sorts of things, and then all of a sudden, we look at the clock, and it's like 5:30 in the morning, and we're like, weird. Oh my gosh. We should probably just go to bed. And we went upstairs. It was like arriving home. It's like coming home. I felt so good. And to know that I was allowed to do this, I wasn't cheating, because it was an open relationship, but it just felt so good. I just really liked this person so much. And so the next day, you know, on my walk of shame home, and I'm on the phone with Kadir and telling him about everything, and, well, not everything, but, you know, everything that he needed to know. And the next several months or weeks, I honestly don't even know, because it was such a crazy time, because it was three nights a week with him and three nights a week with her and one night a week with myself. And just as a word of advice for any of you guys who ever think about, you know, trying to have an open relationship, I highly recommend giving yourself more than one night a week. Really good idea. And it just went like this for a while until I finally just had to take some time, you know, away from both of them. And I just had to meditate and just really feel like, what is it that I really need? Like, I love both of these people so much. And what I, you know, I have to make a choice here because this is not working for me. And it was on the morning of Gay Pride, and I finally decided that, you know, I have to break up with Kadir. And I had said throughout our whole relationship that I didn't want to have an open relationship because I thought I was going to break his heart. And here I was, having to break his heart. But it had to happen. And as he walked away, I broke a little bit of my own heart too at the same time. But as he was walking down the street, I had tears streaming down my eyes. And at the same time, I knew that Gay Pride was that day. And I really, really, really badly wanted to go to Gay Pride. And so I had tears strolling down my face, and I ran upstairs as fast as I could, and I threw on every single rainbow paraphernalia that I could possibly find in my whole closet. And I threw glitter on my face, and the tears were still just streaming down my face. And I ran downstairs, and there was Jeanette on her motorcycle. And I put the fairy wings on. And we rode off to be in the Dykes on Bikes parade. And that was the saddest day, but it was also the happiest day. Because the person that I chose to be with, Jeanette, is the person that I married 3 months ago.